Howdy, everybody. Welcome to the show. You've reached, and you've reached, like it's a voicemail. You're joining me live here for the JRV Morning Show, and we're just now getting ready to drive into Hart Park. You'll have to forgive my dirty windshield. I totally forgot how dirty it was. But hopefully, you guys won't see what I see. You'll just see all the beauty. Yes. So I wanted to come out to Hart Park because I was here yesterday, and I wanted to talk about a theme that we brought up earlier in the week, and that is symptoms, from body symptoms, physical symptoms, from raising our consciousness, also known as ascension symptoms, and some of the things that I think we can feel all of a sudden lost in life, like we had a direction, and then all of a sudden we don't have a direction, and it all feels very uncomfortable. let's see, what else? Okay, so I want to talk about the ascension symptoms that I have been feeling myself, and that would be, as I've talked about this week, my Kundalini energy has been rising from my root chakra, and it's been slowly working its way up through my different chakras. Yesterday I felt some of the energies penetrating through my throat and third eye chakra, which was a good feeling, even though that might be strange, because I knew that it was rising past my root and sacral chakras, where it has been causing quite a bit of discomfort. I've been feeling really achy in my legs and hips, like I've been having growing pains. Like I'm being stretched, and I feel like it has been really clearing some things out of my root chakra, allowing me to, do whatever is required, allow my body to do whatever is required, to move this energy, to move my Kundalini, to allow it to continue to move up, just like the caduceus of the medical industry, the two snakes going up that central spot, post, so to speak, in that symbol. That's representative of our spine. The snakes are representative of our rising Kundalini energy. And so it's no accident that the medical industry has such a symbol and is utilizing such a symbol. That symbol, I believe, is goes back a lot further than our medical industry, at least our what we know it to be now. So, what I have been doing, the reason why I'm here at Hart Park today, and I wanted to bring you all here, was because this is where I come to get by the river when I want to be around a lot of tree energy, when I want to just clear my energy and allow it to move. I wanted yesterday to be by the river, so I'm going to be taking you by the spot I was yesterday to do the show. Watch out, birds! and because but being by the river is assisting in helping me be in the flow, be in my flow, allowing that Kundalini energy to move, assisting it to move. And so I've also been taking baths, adding Epsom salt. Oh, we got a raccoon. baths with Epsom salt. I've also been adding rose petals from roses in my garden. And my team told me that is a way to bring in the current solar energy, because it's the buds. Oh, look at the, I don't know if you can see her or him, but we have a peacock. Hold on. Hello, Mr. Peacock. Hi, you're so pretty. Look at that blue color, everybody. Beautiful. Okay, so adding the rose petals really helps to tune to the current solar energies, current solar frequencies. We've been having solar flares again, also some coronal mass ejections from the sun, from these holes that open up in the sun and allow these solar streams to come towards the earth. Anyways, it's charging up the earth's atmosphere with the light particles, highly charged energy. And so again, those that are sensitive may feel may feel these energies moving. Again, it can cause these higher energies when they come in onto the planet. They can have a activating effect on our DNA. Okay, so here's the river. So I feel like this is the spot. Although I see him mowing over there, so I'm just gonna, well, this works. I'm gonna park. I'm gonna park here and then walk. We'll walk. Oh no, there's all kinds of trees though. Let me see if I can hear him. I can't. I'm just gonna pull down a little further. And then that way we don't have to compete with the lawnmower noise, because I'm not sure how much longer that's going to be. Excuse me. Oh, okay, but so I would be lying to you if I said that raising your consciousness was all fun and games and easy breezy and didn't have any kind of what we from our humanness would consider negative or uncomfortable symptoms, sensations within our body, especially, you know, again, for those that are really sensitive, all these different sensations can start moving within us and can cause us to start to panic a little bit. Because we're like, oh my God, you know, I'm dying because I feel, you know, crazy. I feel these crazy things. What's going on with me? Something must be wrong. And so I would just caution, what we think about, we bring about, and whatever we're putting out there is going to become part of our reality. And so, I would suggest doing whatever you can to, sorry guys, I'm just trying to find a good spot. I would do whatever you can to keep yourself as positive as possible, not from a Pollyanna sort of perspective, where you're ignoring what's really going on all around you, but you realize that you're in more control over it than you might have previously given yourself credit for. You're more powerful, and so it's important to remember that you're co-creating this reality. You are not at the mercy of it. And so again, it's important to ask for assistance from our team, our light aligned teams that are angels, archangels, ascended masters, great beings of light. These are different higher vibrational cultures that have already ascended, that are already fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh dimensional beings here to assist us in this process. We are not alone in this. There are definitely those that would like to hijack us, but again, we focus on that, then we bring it to us. We don't focus on that, we don't. We don't open up our energy field to it if we're not worried about it or putting energy towards it. So keep your focus towards your own company, your own company of heaven, your own light aligned team. I see it as like the Verizon commercial where, you know, he used to walk around and all the people were always around him. Can you hear me now? Can you hear me now? It's the same thing with the angels. There's like, and all of our teams, you know, it's just all these beings, tons, hundreds, thousands, you know, all around us at any given time, assisting us in our journey. And it is super important to engage with them. They're really extensions of us. They are part of the, let's see, how do I want to say this? They are part of our energetic selves, our bigger selves that are bigger than this human body. Okay, so let me get out of the car. We're going to get over by the river, and then we're going to keep on going with the show. It's 11:09, so I'm sure by the time I get set up, we'll be doing the meditation, then we'll get into the card reading of the day, and we'll go from there. All right. Let's see how this works here. All right. There we go. Now we have the river behind us. We got a nice flowy energy. I'll do my best not to move too much because I can see that I'm on this table. And every time I breathe even, it seems like it moves or jiggles. So if that gets to be too much for those of you tuning in and joining in live, and again, good morning, welcome to the show. Thank you for tuning in with me this morning. Let me know and I'll move the camera onto the ground so that way we don't have to, if it becomes bothersome. I just feel like from our vantage point, it's kind of nice to be higher because then I can catch the river from a different angle from where we're at. Okay, so I'm sure it is ready. Thank you, Aaron. I appreciate the confirmation. And again, welcome. Good morning. It's always great to have you join the show and bringing in all of your big energy and your Light Align team all with you as well. I appreciate it and I'm grateful. And so now, everybody, let's close our eyes and begin to grow roots from the base of our spine and the bottoms of our feet down into the center of Mother Earth. This is truly connecting us to the Earth's energy consciously, giving us an opportunity to also extend our love and gratitude and appreciation. And also, this is what is animating our current reality, our personality, our personal realities, our gifts and abilities, and all that we know to be in this realm and beyond. Okay, now I would like you to become aware of your gold and silver ball of light representing your divine spark and your ability to grow that divine spark bigger, 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 bigger. And we're going to grow that divine spark out in the form of a sphere, a golden silver ball of light that is emanating all around us, past our physical body, past our physical body suit. And we're going to take it out to 33 feet today. 33 feet. Yes. And again, that's a perfect sphere all around you. You're in the center. It's animated and emanated from the internal limitless source within you that is you. And so this is a great space and place to be when you really want to be in your own energy. For those empaths out there that really easily take on other people's energy, this is a great space to be in order to create a boundary between you and everyone else. And another way to do that, to add to this visualization, would be to mirror both sides of your sphere. Mirroring on the inside, mirroring back all of your energy back at you, and mirroring the outside, mirroring back all the energy that is outside of you, mirroring it back to wherever it belongs. Again, creating an even more, let's see, how do I want to say this? An even more perceptible barrier, not barrier, it's not a barrier, boundary, healthy boundary between you and everyone and everything else. Really assisting you in getting to know your energy. Yes. All right, wonderful. Okay, so today we're going to really continue for those that are having their Kundalini energy moving as well in these higher energy times. And for those that would like to really just allow the energy to move through your body freely, we're going to work with the earth energy, especially being right here next to the water, this river that is flowing behind me. We're going to begin to, from our roots, pull up the crystalline, white, pure liquid energy. It's like a water crystal energy from the earth. It's a watery substance, but it's full of light, so it's got this white light about it. And we're going to begin to pull that up through our roots, filling up our feet, our ankles, our calves, filling up our knees, continuing to pull it up through our thighs, our genital area, our root chakra, filling up even higher into our lower abdomen, going up even higher into our stomach, really bathing all of our organs in this beautiful earth energy that is full of the cosmic light as well as the nurturing energy of the earth. We are from the earth. This is where we are having this particular incarnation. This is the reality that's important because this is the reality we're conscious in. And we're continuing to bring it up through our heart space, up, 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 out, down through our arms, out through our hands, raining down back to the ground, continuing up, up, up through our neck, clearing our throat chakra, continuing up through our face, back of our head, clearing our third eye, and then continuing up, raining out through our crown chakra, that's at the top of our head, raining back out down to the earth. And we're just going to imagine this energy continuing to come up and out. And if you are feeling anywhere where there is anything stuck or not quite wanting to move, again, just imagine this energy like a flowing river, just carrying away, just allowing this blockage to dissolve and allowing the water to take it and continue to move this energy. And again, it's all coming up out the top of your head and raining back down to the earth. We're just gonna let this energy move and groove. It feels really good. I know I'm enjoying it very much. Ooh. Let's take a deep breath together. Another one, filling up our stomach. All right, wonderful. Okay, so let's start to become aware of our physical body again, beginning to wiggle our fingers and toes and opening our eyes whenever we are ready. So that felt really good. Again, we are not at the mercy of what's going on with us. In fact, we are the ones co-creating it. And so when we engage within the energy, when we work in this way, we are working within the energy matrix in order to show the universe, this is what I want to create for myself. This is where I want to head. This is what I want to go towards. This is what I want to experience. But if we're not telling the universe those things, then that means someone's telling the universe on our behalf. So it's really important to really come in and really let the universe know, just like a computer, what we want. So this is one of the ways in which we do that. All right, let's do the card reading of the day. So we're gonna check in and see for the collective. Energies are moving and grooving. Let's see which card most represents that moving and grooving energy today for the collective. I don't know if you can hear the pow, pow, pow in the background, but there's a shooting range, so it sounds like a mini war is going on, but it's not. It's just a shooting range, everybody. We're in Bakersfield. All right. Ah, reverence. Reverence. This is a fun card. Looks like there's electricity coming out of his crown chakra. That's how I feel. Okay. So reverence, it's kind of, I feel like, has a little religious connotation to it, like reverence for God and Jesus. That's at least the kind of vibe I get from my time back as a Christian, going to church every Sunday. Reverence, though, how I see it now and what I feel like this card is representing is the whole idea that there's a reverence for life, our own life, life of other fellow humans around us, as well as life, as all the life evolving on this planet and beyond, beyond this planet, like truly understanding that we are a part of this alive reality, this alive universe, and that if we shit on or poo-poo on any of it, we're really shitting on and poo-pooing on the universe, and because we're part of the universe, we're really shitting and poo-pooing on ourselves. So, so how's that for you? Pardon, I had a call coming through. We had to decline that call really quick. And so, reverence, really understanding and appreciating our own energy, our own gifts and abilities. And so for the collective, I see that there, as these new energies are coming to the surface for us to play with, so to speak, within ourselves, in the collective, as more truth comes to light, as more people feel inspired to become detectives, to figure out and find out what's going on, as well as begin to take back their co-creative abilities to create what they would like to create versus what they thought they needed to create because society told them so, or religion told them so, or the government told them so, or the doctors told them so, or their teacher told them so, or the news told them so, or some TV show told them so, or some of their favorite movie characters told them so, or their mom or dad told them so, or their best friend told them so. It's coming back to ourself, realizing that we don't need to get approval from anyone other than ourself. And again, I'm not talking about children. This is all directed towards adults. But it's time to become an adult within yourself and realize that it's important for you to make your own decisions, be your own authority, do whatever research is required for you to fill in the gaps, and not just believe everything you're told and not... believe something because some authority figure told you. That's just it's lunacy, and it's, I know, easy because we have doctors that think they're gods, and you know they get mad when you ask them questions or they feel like you're questioning them and how dare you. You know what? That's none of your business how they are affected by your questions or by your concerns or by you showing that you have your own thoughts. Do it anyways. Let's see. I'm not sure where that came from, but that must be for somebody. That felt very specific. let's see. Reverence. Okay, so again, too, just like in this card, just on the last note, the energy shooting out through the crown, that's really cosmic awareness. Cosmic understanding, bigger picture awarenesses and understandings that are becoming available. But again, you must tune in and say yes to these energies, yes to this knowledge and information in order to bring it into your own personal awareness. Even though it's swimming around in the collective, you must make it personal for yourself. All right, so that completes the card reading of the day. Wonderful. Again, we're out here at Hart Park. Again, one of my favorite places to come. It's pretty close to where I live now on the east side of town. So it makes it easier than ever to come enjoy this beautiful park. Like I said, I love all the trees. It's one of the parks that has the most mature trees. There's some lakes, as well as the river going behind me that goes through the park. And I just really feel like it's a place where all the elemental beings really love to hang out and recharge themselves. And so it just feels like a very healing place. And like I said before, when we're going through these body changes, these different energies wanting to move, it's important to really listen to our bodies and follow through with what our inner guidance says. So one of them was be by the water, come to the river. The other was take the ceremonial bath with myself, you know, adding Epsom salt with some of my essential oil blends, as well as the rose petals, bringing in candles and stones and crystals, calling in my entire Light Aligned team to join me and assist. That really has helped. I've been taking like 2 baths a day because it's been really intense, the achiness. And especially now that it's moving up, it's like a different kind of sensation. But in a way, it kind of feels better because it's like my lower back was just something else.
it doesn't seem to be causing the same level of discomfort as it's moving up through the rest of my back. Just so you know, I've had to take Advil a couple times, and so I might have some Judge Judy's out there like, oh my God, he took Advil. oh my God, I did, and I didn't die. The energy is still moving. I didn't stop it. Again, I'm not saying that Advil, you know, is for you, and I don't take it on a regular basis. However, there was just some moments where it just got to be too much, and I had had enough, and I took a couple Advil to assist in bringing that pain level down. Again, you have to make those choices for yourself. I'm not saying what to do or not to do in your situation. I'm just letting you know what I've done, and that it's important not to judge the hell out of yourself for these things. Because when we judge ourselves, that is what's really creating the discordant reality more than anything that we could do in this reality, if that makes sense. It's more about what energy, what thought processes, oh, here we go again, or I can't believe I did that, or oh, I'm weak because I took Advil. You know, whatever it is that we tell ourselves, that, you know, we get into these mind roller coasters, these really downward spiraling mind viruses, those are more detrimental than anything else that we could have, you know, take necessarily. It's our thought processes behind it. It's what we think about it that's more important, as far as I'm concerned. Again, my perspective, this is something you have to play with and figure out for yourself. Because I don't want to hear how I did the da 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 because Jay said so. I didn't say any of that. You have to decide from your own internal guidance system, from your own place that you play, how best to make decisions for you. I can't tell you how to make decisions. All I can do is let you know how I make decisions, and then you can, you know, you're still going to have to take that within and decide for yourself. How do you want to do it? You know, that's what this life's about, is you getting to make decisions on your own, not because someone told you so, but because you decided you want to do it. That's the way you are empowering yourself to be the one in control of your life, driving the car, making your own choices. That is part of this process. I knew a butterfly just flew by. Divine. Transformation. Okay. I think that's it for today. I want to thank everybody for joining me here at the Hart Park, right here by the Kern River behind me, today for today's show. It feels really good. I'm feeling really good just being here again, so I'm glad that I came back. And yeah, that's going to do it. I want to thank everybody that tuned in live, as well as that joined in the archives. And before I tune out, I want to remind everybody, or let everybody know, because I forgot earlier this week, that I'm going to be at the Powwow Vitality Collective this afternoon from 2 to 7 for their Customer Appreciation Day. Again, the Powwow Vitality Collective, it's downtown on 24th Street, right when you're coming down off the 178. And I will be there from 2 to 7, set up with my essential oil sprays and oils for people to experiment and sample, as well as to purchase. It's a great time for those that partake in cannabis products. They have all kinds of products available, as well as some other vendors that are there with samples. All you would need is your little card stating that you have a valid marijuana license, whatever they're called, and then and your own driver's license, and then that gets you in the door. Okay, I believe that's it now. Thank you again for tuning in and joining me. It was a great show. I loved coming out here. I want to wish everybody a fantastic weekend. I am available for private sessions if anybody would like to go deeper and would like to do this in a way that is all focused and directed at you personally. Let me know, give me a call, or go to my website and click on book an appointment, and go from there. But until Monday, I want to surround everybody, and I am surrounding everybody, with a big, huge, giant hug of love. Until Monday, we'll see you then. Bye-bye, everybody.